My dear friends, welcome to a new video. And today I would like to introduce to you the essential things I like in hotel rooms. We are starting here with the breakfast on the terrace. By the way, if a hotel needs more than 30 minutes to deliver the breakfast to your room, the guests will not like it. So make your notes if you're a hotel owner. I show you some more essential things right now. One thing I find essential in a hotel is to have a good room control console next to your bed. Room control console, try to say that 10 times in a row. So here, I thought that's a starter. So I think nowadays this is relatively out fashion. It always should have a USB charger next to the bed. However, here I had to bring my own one. So, and if you don't have a console next to your bed, I always recommend to get a little bit longer charger cable so you can make sure the whole night the phone is next to your head. Also, it should always be possible to switch on the do not disturb sign directly from your bed, because there's nothing worse to come out of the shower and to realize I have to do it manually. Hopefully nobody's passing the door. No! So in order to avoid that scenario, here at least you have a button on the inside in the room. So if you just come out the shower, do not disturb, but ideally do it before. And we have, of course, the master light switch here, which brings us again back to the topic. Room control console, say it 10 times. There's nothing more painful than having a complicated room control console. This one here has a master switch. And like in nearly all hotels in the world, it works, except of this bastard over there. So in 999 hotels out of 1,000, it is this lamp which doesn't want to go off with the master switch. And then you have to figure out how to switch the bastard off. Is it here, here, is it that one? No, that's the balcony light. Oh. And at that point of time, you're so annoyed that you need 30 minutes longer to fall asleep. This hotel is equipped with a spare toilet paper roll holder. Also a word you should say 10 times in a row. And I tell you why this is so important. Just have a look at this scenario. Hi. I ran out of toilet paper. Could you please send some to the room? Yeah? Okay. What do you mean you cannot enter because the do not disturb sign is switched on? And in this room we have that beautiful, beautiful bathtub which opens with that door to the rest of the room. I think many hotels make it to make the room to appear very open. In my opinion, it only makes sense if you can see the TV from the bathtub. So let's have a look here if we can do that. Let's open that. And well, you could maybe enjoy the view towards the sea, but you cannot see the TV. So what's the point? Oh, wait a minute. Not always the hotel can make mistakes. Sometimes you might have untrustworthy guests. Oh. High security. Very good. One essential part for me, as you might have realized already, is the mini bar, because maybe in the evening you want to have a drink on the terrace, maybe one in the shower, on the bathtub. Let's have a look at this mini bar. Oh my God, are you kidding me? Guys, this is not acceptable. COVID, yes or no, but if you have a mini bar, it has to be full of drinks. This one, not even worth looking at. Nevertheless, I always like a great terrace, and this one here, it's another thing, unnecessary furniture, not even a cushion on it. So, and here my tutorial comes to an end. And if you are a hotel owner and you have identified the same problems which I just showed you here, then you should take action immediately for the happiest guest alive and for the best TripAdvisor reviews from your guests ever. Especially the minibar thing is a big deal, huh? Okay, see you next time. Bye.